babe. It is a beautiful day. I'm at Dunky right now. We're getting crunky with Dunky. I just woke up this morning. Yesterday was a nice day, I guess. I didn't really do that much. Went to work, went home, chilled. Dunkin' getting my coffee. I'm supposed to be out today. It's 5:55, period. So, yeah. Okay, guys, so I basically got my coffee already from Dunkin'. I was supposed to be out today, but because I was late going in on Alaska's first day of school, so that I went to take her to school, that deduced my hours. So I'm going in on a day that I have off to make up my hours. I don't know if I'm gonna split up my hours into two different days because it's actually 8 hours that I have to make up. So I'm like, do I go in on both my days off and just have like a short, cute little work day and then like the rest of the day to myself? Or do I have one full day off? Because see, this morning I was gonna sleep in and go in late, but since my brain already woke me up, I'm already up. So it's like, might as well go. You know what I mean? Otherwise I'm just gonna be wasting time around in the bed. So it's like, I might as well do stuff. And that's how I feel about my days off. I'm like, what do I do on my days off anyway? Like, if I have a day off, then that means I'm gonna be spending money doing something, and I really don't wanna be spending money anywhere. The only thing to do is make money and not spend money. So yeah, anyways, I'm on my way to work. It looks like a beautiful Wednesday to me so far. The vibes are like kind of cute because there's hardly any traffic right now. It doesn't look that bad. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this. Okay guys, I've been like chilling this whole time, but I'm finally at the freaking... Amber was like a lot, and she honestly don't know what I look like. I forgot I was wearing my hair in the bun. So I haven't been here that long. I've literally been here for like 10 minutes or something like that. It was a fiasco when I walked in here. And I wasn't wearing a hat because I forgot where I was for a minute. And so I wasn't ready, but now I'm off. People over here.
Travis is going to tell him he don't want
to
go.
I think so. Or I think he's going to, because he was like, I don't want to be by myself and all this stuff. But he said, I don't think I have a choice. I don't think I have a choice.
Oh, he has got a choice. If he'll let me and you and Chaz and all the rest of us talk to him. See, we're not supposed to go over his head. I mean, right, because we're supposed to go through the chain of command, Travis, you know, Ricky, whatever. Mm-hmm. But if Travis would give us all permission to talk to Ricky and tell Ricky that we all want to stay here as a little group or a little family wants to stay here, he'll probably listen.
I know, I told him, I said, if it's because you want everything to be organized a certain way, if it's be...
Didn't tell me, I said, tell me what to do. Sing about there for 2 weeks and then bring him back.
I said, if it's because it's too unorganized, I said, tell me what to organize and I'll organize it. All that paperwork in there, just tell me what I need to do to organize it and I'll organize it.
Well,
like,
just tell him to send him over there for 2 weeks and get the store straight and send him back. Why couldn't he do that?
Right? I don't know.
See, you got your daughter in school now.
I'm not trying to go all, you know what I mean?
If you got a problem, then you're going to be a lot further away from school.
And traffic.
And traffic.
Two traffic. Because I'll be in traffic and I'll be in the freaking... I don't know if it worked. I'm not entirely sure. Dang, crackheads always take apart our freaking air machine and use the pieces for crack.
Put that in the drawer to replace it.
Whose is that?
It's mine.
Two bags of ice and water.
But if every one of us tossed it to Ricky, do we want to keep him here? Come on, he thinks this store's going to be fucked up. He want to see this one after he's trimmed his car.
For real. My children keep me off these streets. If it wasn't for them, I would be throwing this cat all over town. All over town. There'd be no way around it. I'd be making that money.
No one is calling you every time I tell you where you at. He knows
you
don't.
I know, dude. He does. Red? Green?
We used to go and have a truck and we found it in cases.
I'm taking a little breaky break in my car really quick because I've done a lot, like literally a lot. So, I mean, it might have been like paperwork and computer shit, but I did a lot. Okay, so I'm gonna take a break. Do that, but that is so cool.
When Debbie wants something, Debbie gets it.
I try to.
Or people suffer.
Now we need to get a hold of the Ritz cracker people so they can send Ritz by the pound to Debbie's house. And I'll buy them through her. She'll be my drug dealer.
Dump truck.
These are good though.
Those things are good.
I could just eat the cracker by itself though sometimes. Like even buy a pack of the crackers and just suck on them. They're good. Okay, so me and my manager just went to Zaxby's and there was a freaking huge ass wreck right in front of our job, right there. It's crazy. I don't know what happened, but like 5 or 6 cars were all effed up and it was crazy. And they just took a couple of the cars. There's another car over there on the side of that cop while he's there directing traffic. But anyway, that's not what I was going to tell you. I was going to tell you that I went and got lunch for us. And then they didn't give me my receipt so I can get my Zaxby's points. So then I called Zaxby's and I was like, hey, I just went through there. You know me. I go to Circle K. I work at Circle K. I go there all the time. I was like, y'all didn't give me my receipt, and I really wanted my loyalty points. So can you just give me my loyalty point number over the phone? And then she did. And so I got 370 points for that. Period. But yeah. Anyways, I had got me a refresher at Dunkin' while I was already getting... Because Zaxby's and Dunkin' are like right next to each other. So I went ahead and got me a refresher. Oh my God, it's so crazy, man. There's so many cops over here. And when we were going to Zaxby's, there was a cop that was like going around people because nobody was stopping for the cop. Like the cop obviously had his emergency lights on, but nobody was stopping in traffic and like moving out of his way. So like he was just going around everybody in the opposite line of traffic and it was crazy. And this is where he ended up going, literally right here in front of our Circle K. So that was crazy. But anyway, yeah, I'm out of breath. That was a crazy situation. But yeah, the girl that works at Zaxby's, her name is Lexi, and she knows Debbie because Debbie worked at Zaxby's, so it's crazy because everybody knows us. So this is why we don't want to leave our Circle K, because everybody knows us. Like, why would we want to leave? Yeah. How about you? Hi.